The find command is great as it can deal with many files buried arbitrarily deep in the directory tree. But the syntax is not easy with those backslashes and brackets and so on. Isn't there an easier way to search for files by name? Indeed, there is, at least if you are using a decently written bash shell. In the first part of this mini-series, we use glob patterns to match files. But glob patterns can only match files that are at the same depth in the file system hierarchy. To solve that, in the second part, we use the find command to deal with nested subdirectories, but at the expense of a completely different syntax. In this third part, we will kind of see a mix of both, since I will show you an extension to the classic glob patterns to match files at arbitrary depth. If you remember the second part, you know my video and subtitle files are scattered on several levels of subdirectories, but I want to move all those files in the corresponding top-level folders. From the first part of the series, you know if I want to move all subtitles from the movies folder, I will write that. But that will not move files from any subdirectory. So, in addition, if I want to move all subtitle files currently sitting one level below the movies folder, I will have to explicitly mention it. And if I want files nested two levels below the movies folder, I have to add yet another glob pattern. As you can see, using classic glob patterns, there's no way to express that notion of arbitrary number of subdirectories. And this is exactly what the bash solved by adding the double star glob pattern extension. Unfortunately, we cannot run that command immediately. Why? Because this new syntax introduced a slight risk of incompatibility with existing scripts, so it is usually not enabled by default. At least, it is not on my Debian system. So, I have to explicitly turn it on. And now, it's on in that shell. So the double star will work and will match an arbitrary number of subdirectories. Next, I can do the same to move all .mp4 files into the videos folder. And I will do the same to move all .mkv files. Definitely, this is much easier to remember than the find command syntax. You just have to enable the globstar first. And that concludes our mini-series. Now, you too, you can say, yes, I know three different ways of moving, copying, or doing whatever else with a large number of files in no time. If you like that series, I encourage you to take a look at my bash online course on Udemy. There, I provide a more in-depth introduction to the bash and Linux command line tools. In addition, the course is really task-oriented with many exercises and challenges for you to solve on your own system. If you're interested, go to my website and scroll on to the course page. There, you will be able to register for a great discount coupon. So, don't miss that.